नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयामुदीरये नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवती उत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवती नैष्टिकी। हरे कृष्ण। सो रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद्भागवतम कैंटो 10th चैप्टर 12th द किलिंग ऑफ द डीमन अघासुर टेक्स्ट 35। तत् अद्भुतस्तोत्र सुवाद्य गीतिका जयादि नैकोत्सव मंगलस्वनान श्रुत्वा स्वधाम्नो अन्त्य अज आगतो अचिरात् दृष्ट्वा महिषस्य जगा विस्मयम् तदद्भुतस्तोत्र सुवाद्य गीतिका जयादि नैकोत्सव मंगलस्वनान् श्रुत्वा स्वधाम्नो अन्त्य अज आगतो अचिरात् दृष्ट्वा महिषस्य जगा विस्मयम् तदद्भुतस्तोत्र सुवाद्य गीतिका जयादि नैकोत्सव मंगलस्वना श्रुत्वा स्वधाम्नो अन्त्य अज आगतो अचिरा दृष्ट्वा महिषस्य जगाम विस्मयम् लेडीज word by word meaning that celebration performed by the demigods in the upper planetary system, adbhuta, wonderful, stotra, prayers, suvadya, glorious musical sounds of drums and other instruments, Geetika, celestial songs, Jaya Adi, sounds of joy, etc. Na Eka Utsava, celebrations simply for the glorifying the Supreme Personality of God. Mangalaswanan, transcendental sounds, auspicious for everyone. Shrutva, hearing such sounds. Swadhamna, from his abode. Anti, nearby. Aja, Lord Brahma. Agata, coming there. Achirat, very soon. Drishtva, seeing. Mahi, the glorification. Ishasya, of Lord Krishna. Jagam Vismayam, became astonished. Translation and purport. When Lord Brahma heard the wonderful ceremony going on near his planet, accompanied by music and songs and sounds of joy, joy, he immediately came down to see the function. Upon seeing so much glorification of Lord Krishna, he was completely astonished. Purport. Here the word anti means near, indicating that even in the higher planetary systems, near Brahma Loka, like Maharlok, Janalok and Tapolok, the festival of glorification of Lord Krishna was going on. ॐ ज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपकदामयं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकां नमां विष्णुपदाय कृष्ण प्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी नित्य नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे कौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी अशतादेशतारिणे नमो महावदन्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नामने गौरतिषे नमः। हे कृष्णा करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधो जगत्पते एषा गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसृत देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिय वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्येव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्रीवासदि कौरभक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। हरे कृष्ण। सो आफ्टर हियरिंग दी story of Chilu yesterday. Yeah, back to Brahma's bewilderment. So here in this verse, Shukadeva Goswami is just introducing Brahma, Lord Brahma, who was very inquisitive about what is going on this planet. And there were a lot of celebrations going on, not only on the upper planetary systems, but you are even higher than that. Maharlok, Janalok, Tapolok, and Brahma stays still higher than all these lokas in the abode of Satyalok. So here it is explained that he heard this sounds of Jai Jai, the music and songs were going on. Even the residents of these higher planetary systems, they were celebrating the death of Agasur. And Brahma became more curious. He wanted to know what is going on. There are so many things happening on the earth planet. Lord Krishna is killing so many demons and relieving the distress of the devotees. And we can see that these demons were so powerful that even the residents of these higher planetary systems, they were disturbed. He was creating so much disturbance, these demons, that it was creating a big anxiety for all these people in the upper planetary systems. And it is explained that these residents of these higher planetary systems, they have very long life. They live for many, many years. It is explained that sages like Bhrigu Muni, they live for 4.3 billion years. You cannot imagine what is the time span according to solar years. They live for almost like 4.3 billion years. So although they had such big lifespan, but still these demons were so powerful that they could create an anxiety in the minds of such sages and perfected beings. They have all types of siddhis. It is explained that 8 types of siddhis, these people have naturally anima, lagima, mahima, prakamya, ishita, avashita, like that 8 types of mystic perfections they have. They can become the lighter than the lightest, heavier than the heaviest. They can get whatever they want. But as Lord Krishna explains in Bhagavad Gita that a brahma bhuvana loka punaravartino arjuna, that even on till the highest planet in this material world, brahma loka, down to the lowest planetary systems, patala loka, there is birth, old age, disease and death. Nobody is exempt from that. The fear of death is also there on this planetary systems, or these residents of this higher lokas also have the fear of death. So therefore they are afraid of such demons like Aghasur and other demons. And when they were observing that Krishna is entering in the mouth of Aghasur, he was a big python. This demon came in the form of a big python and expanded his mouth. And Krishna, who is omniscient personality, who knows everything, past, present, future, and is all powerful, he did not have any amount of fear. He very fearlessly entered into the mouth of Aghasur. He expanded inside and he choked this Aghasur. This Aghasur was thinking that I will swallow Krishna, and he will choke Krishna, and Krishna will suffocate and he will die. But exactly opposite thing happened. And it is explained that the life air of Aghasura did not have any space to come out. There was all, his body was inside, there was Krishna inside. So he had blocked everything from within, couldn't come out. So from the top of his head, somehow he just burst out and came. And then finally he merged in the body of Lord Krishna. So Acharya explained that what is this going on here? That these demons also are achieving perfection. Acharya explained that Aghasura achieved Sarupya Mukti, same form of Lord or the residents of Vaikuntha, because he was so much absorbed in thinking of Lord Krishna in a unfavorable way, that he was constantly thinking of the same form, that this form is my enemy and I have to kill. So that was the absorption that they had. Even Kansa later on will see that even he was so much absorbed in thinking of the Lord that ultimately he also achieves similar kind of liberation, Sarupya Mukti. So that is the mercy of the Lord, that how the Supreme Lord, even somebody approaches him in an unfavorable way, still he awards the highest type of liberation. And in this way, when this demon died, there were a lot of celebration. And the upper planetary systems also, they were also celebrating. There were songs, music, and all things were going on. And Krishna is rasovaisaha. He wants to increase the rasa of all the different pastimes. And somehow that he wanted to just bring Brahma, Lord Brahma into picture. Let us see what Brahma is going on the higher planet, still above all these people of the Mahalok, Janalok. They are jubilant, but what about Brahma? Let us check what is going on there. So Krishna is bringing Lord Krishna's attention, Brahma's attention, and Brahma becomes inquisitive. Oh, there is some sound going on. What's going on there? He comes near the planets. And one may wonder that how somebody can see from one planet to another, what kind of vision they have, X-ray vision or some kind of... But it is explained that the people of the higher planet systems have got the higher powers. Our eyes, our senses are limited in this material world. We are born in the darkness of ignorance. We can't see beyond certain limits. If everything becomes dark, we can't see. Or is too much bright also, still we can't see. And so much faith we put on these senses, material senses, that seeing is believing. Material scientists say that seeing is believing. If we can't see, we don't believe. But here, this knowledge has been given on the from the very, very high levels, not for any ordinary mundane scholar who can reach to these levels. Because the senses are limited in the material world. So they can't see beyond certain things. But the people, as we go higher, as somebody progresses from this earthly planetary system, which is also called as Bhurloka, 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 Swargaloka, Bhur, Bhur, Swar. So earthly planetary systems, people have short lives, short memory, senses are limited. But as one goes higher, they develop into many aspects. Their lifespan increases. They have more lifespan. They can live for many, many years, the people on the heavenly planets, Swargaloka. They live for many, many years. And still higher than that is Maharlok, which is considered to be like the neck of the universal form of the Lord. If the earthly planetary systems or the Bhur, Bhur, Swar, they are like the chest, then the neck is the Mahar planetary systems. Then higher than that is Janaloka, which is like the lips of the Supreme Lord of the universal form. Then the forehead is like the Tapoloka, of the people who are just sages, and those are perform great austerities. They reside in such lokas. And head is the Brahma Loka, Satya Loka, where Brahma is residing. So we can understand that as one goes higher, they have more lifespan. They live for many, many years. As we know that Brahma lives for huge, like 311 trillion years something, and 40 million billion years something. Huge lifespan, we cannot imagine. Sahasra yuga paryantam aharyat brahmano vedu. Lord Krishna explains that the 1000 ages taken together, the Satya Loka, Satya Yuga, त्रेता युग द्वापर युग कलयुग इफ वी कंबाइंड ऑल दैट इट बिकम्स वन साइकिल एंड सच थाउजेंड साइकिल टेकन टुगेदर मेक ब्रह्मास 12 hours just 12 hours of Brahma and Brahma lives for 100 years so we can imagine what is the lifespan of Brahma and Brahma this position this is also a position in this universal management it's like a huge management going on in the universe and Brahma is like the creator it is explained that one who is the most perfect being in the universe is given a chance to become Brahma who is very very pious soul who has performed many many pious activities and another place it is explained that a living entity who has performed almost like 100 lifetimes a perfect varnashram system he has followed duties 100 lifetimes then he is allowed to occupy that post to become a Brahma in the universal cosmic management and what a wonderful task he has to perform sometimes we say that Brahma is like the creator he just creates everything but what is this creation what he has done is we just can try to understand that he was the first born living entity in the universe there was no one there around he was just sitting on the top of lotus flower huge gigantic waves of ocean are trying to disturb so he tried to understand his position where he is coming from what is the source he tried to understand going to the bottom of that lotus stem but by his speculation he could not understand so when he meditated then the supreme lord he gave two words in his heart tapa means austerity he told him to perform austerities so Brahma performed austerities for many many years thousands of years he performed austerity then the knowledge of creation was revealed to him tene brahma hrudaya adikavaye that how to create this in this material world secondary creation supreme lord is the first creator he created all the elements 24 elements and everything he created but Brahma is like the engineer he engineers he cannot manufacture these basic elements he just assembles assembly line so he had to do a very very meticulous job and all the living entities so many living entities were going to come and so many planets he had a big task of populating all the universe so many planets he had to see that there are people residing there so 84 lakh species jalancha navalakshani stavaram lakshamyamshati chalaja the aquatics 9 lakhs types of aquatics jalaja narakshani stavaram lakshavimshati trees plants and all that 20 lakhs types of different species krumayo rudra sankhyanka 11 lakhs types of insects and germs and so many microorganisms पक्षिणाम दशलक्षण, 10 lakhs टाइप्स ऑफ बर्ड्स, त्रिमलक्षाणी पाशव, 30 lakhs टाइप्स ऑफ एनिमल्स एंड ऑल द बीस्ट एंड चतुर्लक्षाणी मानव, 4 lakhs टाइप्स ऑफ ह्यूमन बीइंग्स एंड ऑल दीज हैव टू बी somewhat different. They can't be same like just put in the machine and mass production like type of thing. But he had to see that every living entity, all the different entities, they have these different types of desires, 84 lakhs types of desire. And to suit to everyone's desire, he had to create these kind of bodies. So all our bodies have been first created by Brahma. All the DNA structure and all these complicated structures within our body have been first thought by Brahma, who made it possible. And today's world, people, scientists, they get bewildered that how they are not able to understand how these changes are happening, and so many theories are going on that maybe from one species to another species developed, and the whole propaganda is going on. But on this, someone takes the knowledge from these great scriptures, one cannot understand. Just like Srila Prabhupada explains the story of Dr. Frog in the well. Dr. Frog, he meets another frog, and another frog tells that I saw a big ocean. So he tries to understand, oh, how big? He tries to increase his belly. Is that big? No. No. Still no. So Dr. Frog is in the well, small copa. He cannot estimate what can be beyond a small well. He has just limited understanding. The water may be only this much, cannot understand. So similarly, the scientists, they cannot go beyond certain limits. They think that, oh, this is all in all. It happened like this by chance. Everything suddenly exploded and everything fall in place. Perfectly revolving in the orbits and going on for many, many years. That even the some scientists, they understand that it just cannot happen by chance. It is not possible how this kind of gigantic planets, they can float in the sky. It is not possible. There must be some higher intelligence. But they cannot come to understand that the Supreme Lord is the creator of all these planets and universes. Unless they sincerely take shelter of the Supreme Lord, this knowledge will not be revealed to them. So, here Brahma became curious to understand that what is going on. And in the earlier ages, earlier previous ages, and even before AD, almost like 1,000-2,000 years before, there are evidences of people coming from other planets to this planet. So that may be considered to be a mythology in today's world. People of today's world, they may categorize it like the mythological stories. That some beings from other planets, they try to come to this human earthly planets, and they just keep it aside. But in earlier ages, or even at the time of Lord Krishna, we have the incidences where Lord Krishna, he went to heavenly planet with his wife Satyabhama to bring Parijat flower. It was a common story, everyone knows. And devotees, those who have got simple heart, it's not for them difficult for them to accept the facts that Lord Krishna can travel from one planet to another. Or even Srila Narada Muni, who Srila Prabhupada explains that he is a transcendental spaceman. He travels from one planet to another, anywhere he can go. There is no difficulty. He doesn't have to take a space aircraft or something, some special. No scientist have to make a special aircraft for him. He just travels. He has such a power that he doesn't have to worry about anything. And this was a very common, feature in the earlier ages, that people could travel from one planet to another. And even Lord Krishna with Arjuna, he went to almost like to Mahavishnu he went, crossing all the different lokas and went to the higher planets. And so Srila Prabhupada, he explains that going to easy journey to other planets, he explains that it is not difficult. Our ancestors, he explains, that our ancestors have gone and came so many times. Material scientists, they are struggling hard to go to nearest planet, but so many theories are going on. So when even it is explained that after the after one day of Brahma, when there is a partial annihilation, that time the residents of the Maharloka, or they see that there is a water of inundation is coming, so they still can go to higher planetary systems. They have their planes, and from one planet to another they can easily go. There is no difficulty at all. So such kind of mystic siddhis they naturally have. And it is explained that how Brahma also, he had such mystic powers, but when he, without permission of the Lord, he cannot enter into the pastimes of the Lord. He became inquisitive, definitely, what is going on, and tried to see on other planets. But without Krishna's permission, without the attitude of devotion, one cannot enter into these pastimes. So therefore, although he was having so much knowledge, so many mystic powers, fabulous life, but still, by his all power, he could not understand Krishna's power. Because Krishna didn't allow that. How he bewilders Brahma, that we will see in the next chapter. And another time, Lord Chaitanya explains to Sanatana Goswami that once Lord Brahma, he comes to Dwarka to meet Lord Krishna, that let us go and meet Krishna, he is there in Dwarka. So Brahma comes and knocks on the door, Dwarka, so many palaces. So he goes to meet Lord Krishna in Dwarka. So the doorman, he opens the door and sees that there is Brahma. So he goes and informs Lord Krishna that Brahma has come. So Krishna understands that there is some element of pride somewhere, or he is thinking that he is only one. So Krishna tells doorkeeper, and he tells that just ask him which Brahma has come. So the doorkeeper goes and he tells, okay, Lord Krishna is asking, which Brahma are you? So Brahma, with his four heads, he gets bewildered. Right? Which Brahma? What does that mean? are there some more Brahmas? I am the only one. Till that time he was thinking that I am the only one. So Krishna, doorman allows him, okay, come inside. And he comes, and Krishna, by his mystic power, he calls all the Brahmas from different planetary systems. And there are innumerable universes. And all the Brahmas start coming in the palace of Lord Krishna in Dwarka. Some have got 10 heads, some have 100 heads, 1000 heads, and million heads. And they are all coming, and Brahma this, Brahma, he gets bewildered. Oh my God, what is going on? He feels that I am like a mosquito in front of these big, big giants, elephants, types of Brahmas. And then Krishna tells all the Brahmas, oh, so how are you? Everything is okay. I hope no demons are troubling you. And then he sends them back. And then this Brahma, he realizes, oh, I am such a tiny person. I was thinking that I am the only one. But Krishna, he reveals sometimes that what is the position of a living entity. And sometimes this covering potency is so strong. Sometimes one thinks that I am the only one. By me, everything is moving. And everyone should obey me. So like that, things may happen. And even when Srila Prabhupada, he was establishing the movement, and he was empowering his disciples. And at one time, His Holiness Tamal Krishna Goswami Maharaj, there was some management problem, and he was arguing with Prabhupada. Prabhupada, this is happening, that is happening, this temple management is so difficult, deal with that. Then Prabhupada wanted to reveal something. Prabhupada, he started telling that, do you know, there are so many universes. There are millions and billions of universes. And in each universe, there are so many planets, thousands and thousands of planets, and sometimes it takes years, light years, to reach light from one planet to the other. And in these planets, there is one Earth planet, small, tiny speck in the universe. And in this Earth planet, there are so many countries. And in each country, there are so many states and cities and towns, and in one city there are so many buildings, and this is one building where we have this small center. And Tamal thinks that he's the all in all. So then His Holiness Tamal Krishna Goswami Maharaj realized that what is the power of Lord Krishna, and what we think actually, that this covering potency is so strong that we think that we are the only one. So therefore, when the living entity realizes that I am insignificant, and Krishna is all powerful, then only that knowledge will be revealed. We will be in the right disposition of the mind. Sometime before, His Holiness Radhanath Maharaj was explaining that how positive repels positive. If we also try to become like Krishna, then we will not receive the mercy of the Lord. But if we take a very humble position, then the more we go down, the mercy will flow there. Mercy will reach there, some other. So when we have that type of attitude, then we'll be able to receive the mercy of the Lord, the Almighty, who is very difficult to achieve. We cannot achieve the Supreme Lord by our austerities, tapasya. Sometimes we may do Nirjal Ekadashi. Big tapasya, we may think that every Ekadashi is Nirjal. Or whatever, so many fastings we do, and or we try to acquire huge amount of knowledge, vast, all the books, scriptures, but still, Jnane Prayaso Tapasya Namante, Lord Brahma later on prays that even you cannot understand, we cannot understand the Supreme Lord by knowledge, knowledge potency. Bhaktya tu ananya shakya. That Krishna can be understood only by devotional service. So therefore, somebody may perform big austerities, tapasya, or even may remain celibate, brahmacharis. But it is explained that even they reach maximum somewhere Maharlok, Janalok, the highest perfected sannyasis, they may reach to Tapalok, like that. But if somebody wants to cross beyond that and go beyond the universe, then one has to take shelter of devotion. Because even it is explained that the spiritual world is guarded by dikpals. There are people in the different directions standing with their tridents in their hands, and somebody tries to enter those planets by through knowledge or austerities, they get cut by these tridents and they fall back again in this mortal world. So they cannot reach that supreme destination just by performing huge amount of tapasya, austerities or knowledge. When somebody performs devotional service in this mortal world, then one will become purified. Because by as a spirit soul, the spirit soul is completely pure. Satchidananda. It has all the powers as Brahma is having huge amounts of powers, because he is also a living entity like us, but he is more purified. Our soul is more covered with darkness and anarthas and so many things which have to be cleansed up. Therefore, as long as these anarthas are not cleaned up, we cannot perceive the higher things. And therefore, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu explains that Cheto Darpana Marjana, that one should cleanse the mirror of the heart. The heart is considered to be like a mirror, which has been covered with a lot of dust now. But if we hear these pastimes, we chant the holy names of the Lord, which is the Yuga Dharma for this age, with a proper disposition of the mind. Otherwise, while performing even devotional service, one may become proud. He may think that I am the only one who is most qualified, and I am the only one to receive the mercy of the Lord. That even that type of pride is not allowed in the spiritual world. So therefore, when one becomes completely humble, Trunadapi Sunichana Tarurapi Sahishnu Amanina Mana Dena Kirtanya Sada. So when somebody chants the holy name in this consciousness, Krishna consciousness is our original consciousness. So when somebody chants in this consciousness, then the original consciousness will be revealed. Because the holy name and the Supreme Lord are not different. They are on the transcendental platform. Being spiritual in nature, they are transcendental. The Supreme Lord's name, His stories, kathas, nama, rupa, guna, lila, His archa vigraha, pratima nahi tumi sakshat vrajendra nandan. The Supreme Lord is not different from His form. But we can't see that, that the Supreme Lord is standing there playing on His flute, performing His pastimes. With this material eyes we cannot see, because still we are able to see materially, but still we have got covering, material covering is there. So when that covering becomes clear, then we will start seeing everything purely. So therefore, then we will not think that this is only a marble statue. Our eyes will become purified. Therefore, Brahma, he prays in Brahma Sanhita that Premanjana Churita Bhakti Vilochanam Santa Sadeva Rudeshu Vilokayanti Yama Shama Sundaram Achinta Guna Surupam Govendam Adipurusham Tamam. He explains that when our eyes become anointed with Premanjan, with our love, then only we'll be able to see everything clearly. Then we'll see that there is a Shyam Sundar form of Lord standing, playing on His flute. So, therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu explains that this is the process, purification process, Cheto Darpana Marchana. And in this Kali Yuga, this process has been made very simple. Kalota Dhari Kirtana. Simply by chanting the holy names of the Lord, we do not have to perform big austerities or acquire huge amounts of knowledge, or perform tapasya or use sacrifices or deity worship. But just by chanting the holy name, that's the ultimate Yuga Dharma. And with the right disposition of the mind, Trunadapi Sunechena Tarorat, that is the right disposition, then only one will be able to reach to these higher levels of understanding, and then it will become easy to accept such facts that Brahma can just peep into other planets. What is going on other planets? What is His vision? There will not be any difficult to accept such facts. Otherwise, somebody tries to understand with their material senses, then one will become completely bewildered. And he will keep these stories as a mythology, as has been going on in today's world. So therefore, this is the true knowledge, actually, spiritual knowledge, Raja Vidya, Raja Vyam. This is what is required to be taught. And therefore, our acharyas also, in the same mood, they pray that even I don't want to become Brahma. If I become a small insect as a devotee, kita janma hu hau jatha tuva das, bahirmukha Brahma janme nahi ash. Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur is explaining that I do not desire to become Brahma. Externally I may be Brahma, but I want to become the kit, the insect. If that insect gets the Mahaprasad of the devotees of the Lord, then I better prefer that position. So therefore, Srila Prabhupada has given this society in which we can practice this process of chanting, dancing, taking Krishna Prasadam, because once our senses become purified, Ata Sri Krishna Namadi na bhaved grahyam indriye sevon mukhe jivado swayam eva spurat. Once our senses become purified, then we'll start seeing everything clearly. Hare Krishna. Anybody has any question or comment? हरे कृष्ण ग्रंथराज श्रीमद्भागवतम की जय श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय